Hello kids, how are you? Hope you all are having a good time. I wish you health and wellness. Myself, Komal Kaur Sethi, representing Shiv Jyoti Educational Group, Kota. Children, today I'm here to teach you English text. In this, we will study Chapter 11, Jean and the Chimps. So kids, open your book and take out page number 97. Children, this story is about famous person called Jane Goodall. Okay, she is famous for her studies on chimpanzees. Okay, so children, in this story we will learn what new thing she learned about chimpanzees and what are the reaction of chimpanzees towards her. So children, before starting, I would like you to point your index finger where I am reading and keep your pencils along with you to mark the hard words. Let's begin our chapter. Chapter 11, Jean and the Chimps. Jean Goodall loved animals. So children, Jean Goodall, who is famous for her studies on chimpanzees, loved animals very much, okay? As a child, she loved watching animals for hours. So children, when she was a child, she loved to watch animals for hours, okay? She wanted to know everything about them, what they eat and how they live. Underline the word L-I-V-E, live. So children, she wanted to know everything about them, that how they live, what they eat, okay? After finishing school, Jane went to Africa for work. So children, when her school was finished, she went to Africa, okay? Her job was to watch chimpanzees and write about them. Underline the word C-H-I-M-P-A-N-Z-E-E-S, chimpanzees. Who are chimpanzees? Chimpanzees are small, intelligent animals, okay? They live mostly in Africa. So, her job was to watch chimpanzees and write about them, okay? She wrote about them. So, she moved to Gombe where the chimps lived. Underline the word G-O-M-B-E, Gombe over here. What is Gombe, children? Gombe is a small forest in Tanzania, famous for its chimpanzees, okay? It is a small forest in Tanzania, famous for its chimpanzees. So, she wanted to learn more about chimpanzees. So, she moved to Gombe where the chimps lived. Here, word chimp is used for chimpanzees, okay? Every morning, Jane walked into the forest. Underline the word F-O-R-E-S-T, forest. So every morning, what she did? She walked into the forest, okay? Climbed to a peak and looked for chimps. Underline the word P-E-A-K, peak. What is the meaning of peak? Peak is the highest point of mountain, okay? So she climbed to peak and looked for chimpanzees. I want to learn new things about them, she wrote in her diary. Underline the word D-I-A-R-Y, diary. So children, what she did? She want to learn more about chimpanzees and that she wrote in her diary. She is in habit of keeping diary. So she wrote in her diary that I want to learn new things about them, okay? In the beginning, the chimps stayed away from Jane. Sometimes she couldn't see them for many days. So children, what happened in the beginning? Chimps stayed away from Jane because they are scared of her, okay? Sometimes she couldn't see them for many days. She could only hear their pant hoot calls to one another. Underline the word P-A-N-T, pant, H-O-O-T, hoot, C-A-L-L-S, calls. Pant hoot calls. What are pant hoot calls? Pant hoot calls are the sounds made by chimpanzees, okay? So sometimes she could not see them for many days, but what she can hear? She can hear their pant hoot calls, sounds made by chimpanzees, okay? But the chimps too were watching Jane. After a few weeks, the chimps slowly let Jane see them. So when she can't see them for days, she can only hear the pant hoot calls. That time chimpanzees were seeing that how much caring she is towards chimpanzees, how sweet she is. So what they did, they slowly let her see them, okay. Jean was very excited. Underline the word excited, excited. So children, by this, when chimpanzees let her see them, she is very excited, very happy, okay. She gave each chimp a different name. To her, every chimp was special. Underline the word different, different, special, special. So to her, every chimpanzee special, special means different from other. So she gave each chimpanzee different name, okay. Then one day, a chimp with a grey beard came close to Jean. So children, one day what happened? A chimp with grey beard came close to Jean, okay. She had named him David Greybeard. So children, to her, every chimpanzee is special. This time she named this greybeard chimpanzee what name? David Greybeard, okay. Jean offered him bananas. Underline the word offered, offered. So she offered some bananas to David Greybeard, okay. David Greybeard took bananas from my hands. She wrote in her diary that day. So children, she is in habit of maintaining diary. So it is very special for her that David Greybeard took bananas from her hand. So here she wrote in her diary that David Greybeard took bananas from my hands, okay. Jean learned many new things about chimps. So there in Tanzania, in Gom, she learned many new things about chimpanzees, okay. She found out that chimps could make and use tools. Underline the word tools, tools. What are tools? Tools are equipments which make our work more easy, like hammer, pen, pencil. These all are tools that make our work more easy, okay. Machines, these all are tools. So there she found out that chimps could make and use tools, okay. Before this, nobody knew that wild animals made tools. So children, before this, nobody knows that chimpanzees or wild animals can make tools and use them, okay. She saw David Greybeard eat meat. Before this, everybody thought chimps only ate plants. So children, there she also learned that David Greybeard can eat meat, okay. And before that, all thought that chimpanzees can only eat plants, okay. So there she learned two things about them. First is that chimpanzees can make and use tools, and second is they can eat meat also, okay. Slowly the chimps let Jean come even closer. They even let her sit among them. Underline the word among. Among means in the middle of. So children, slowly slowly chimps get more familiar with her. So they let Jean come even closer. They even let her sit among them. So one day what happened? She is sitting in middle of all of them. She is sitting among them, okay. Chimps all around me. What a day, she wrote. So this is also a very special day when she is sitting among all of them, in middle of them. So she wrote in her diary, chimps all around me. What a day. For years, Jane spent most of her time among the chimps. So children, for years, she is there in Tanzania, living among chimps, learning more about them, okay. She watched the chimps when they were happy. She saw them hold hands, hug, kiss and laugh just like people. So children, there she also learned they are just like us, they are just like human beings. They can hold hands, they can kiss, they can laugh, okay. Jane watched the chimps when they were angry or scared. Underline the word angry, angry. So children, Jean also noticed them when they are angry or scared, okay? She even saw them fight, but she kept out of the way. Kept out of the way means to stay away. So children, she saw them fighting, but she stayed away. She kept herself out of the way, okay? At the same time, forests in Africa were being cut down and animals were losing their homes. So children, when she was there in the forest among chimpanzees, what happened? Forests are being cut down and animals were losing their homes, okay? Jean's friends were in danger. Underline the word D-A-N-G-E-R, danger. So children, when forests were cutting down, her friends who are her friend, chimpanzees are her friend. So they were in danger because they were losing their homes, okay? So Jean left Gombe and traveled all over the world. Underline the word T-R-A-V-E-L-L-E-D, traveled. She asked people to help save the chimps and the forest. So children, Jean left the Gombe and she traveled all around the world. Traveled mean to move from one place to another. Why she traveled? Why she moved from one place to another? Because she wanted to make people understand importance of animals and their home. And what is the home of animals? Home of animal is forest. She wanted to protect forest and her friends, okay? Jean returned to Gombe whenever she could. So she returned to Gombe whenever it is possible for her and whenever she was free, okay? She watched and listened again to her friends in the forest. Underline the word L-I-S-T-E-N-E-D, listen. So children, there she watched them and listened to them again when it is possible for her, because she loved to watch animals for hours, okay? We have learned that. So she spent most of her time there when it is possible for her. So children, our chapter is over here. I hope you enjoyed this. Now we will see some hard word of this chapter on board. So children, some hard words of this chapter are, number one is L-I-V-E, live. Then chimpanzees, C H I M P A N Z E S, chimpanzees. Then Gombe, G O M B E, Gombe. Then forest, F O R E S T, forest. Then peak, P-E-A-K, peak. Then diary, D-I-A-R-Y, diary. Then pant, hoot, calls, okay? These are the sounds made by chimpanzees, okay? Pant, hoot, calls. What is the spelling? P-A-N-T, pant, H-O-O-T, hoot, C-A-L-L-S, calls. Pant, hoot, calls. After that, excited, E-X-C-I-T-E-D, excited. Then different, D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-T, different. Then special, S-P-E-C-I-A-L, special. After that, offered, O-F-F-E-R-E-D, offered. Then tools, T-O-O-L-S, tools. Then among, A M O N G, among. Then angry, A-N-G-R-Y, angry. Then danger, D-A-N-G-E-R, danger, okay. Then traveled, T-R-A-V-E-L-L-E-D, traveled, okay. One more word is there, that is listened. L-I-S-T-E-N-E-D, listen. So children, these are the new words, these are the hard words, learn them thoroughly, okay. Now we will move to bookwork of this chapter. Let us do the bookwork of this chapter. Understanding the story, question A. Chimps and humans are similar in many ways. Mark these statements as true or not true. Okay, so children, chimps and human beings are similar in many ways, we have seen in the chapter. So you have to mark true or not true for them. Okay, let us see number one sentence. Chimps and humans both can make tools. Yes, children, we have seen in the stories that chimpanzees can also use and make tools. So this statement is true. Write T over here, okay? We have to write T for true. Number two, chimps and humans both only eat plants. So children, in the story, we have learned that David Greybeard can eat meat and they can also eat plants. So this statement is not true, okay? You have to write NT for not true over here, okay? Number three, chimps laugh and play just like humans. So this statement is true, okay? Write down T over here. Number four, chimps never get angry or scared. This statement is false. They are just like humans. They can be scared or they can be angry. Okay, chimps never get angry or scared. Write down not true over here, N and T. Number five, humans fight with each other but chimps never fight. This is also not true. Okay, write down not true over here. Let us move to next question. Enjoying the story, question A. What do these lines tell us about Jane Goodall? Pick the most suitable answers from the box. So children, some answers are given to you in a box and you have to tell about the nature of Jane Goodall by reading some sentences, okay? Number A, as a child, she loved watching animals for hours. Given answers to you are loved animals, wanted to learn more, worked hard, was kind and caring. So children, we choose that Jane Goodall loved animals. So this sentence show us that Jane Goodall loved animals, okay? As a child, she loved watching animals for hours. This sentence shows us that Jane Goodall loved animals, okay? Now look at B. Every morning, Jane walked into the forest, climbed to a peak and looked for chimps. So this statement shows that Jane Goodall worked hard, okay? Her duty, her job is to look after chimpanzees and write about them. So she worked very hard, okay? Jane Goodall worked hard. Number C, Jane learned many new things about chimps. So answer for this is Jane Goodall wanted to learn more. So children, this statement shows us that she wanted to learn more about chimpanzees, okay? That Jane learned many new things about chimps. What are the new things? That they can eat meat also, that they can use and make tools also, okay? Number D, Jane asked people to help save the chimps and the forest. This tells us that Jane Goodall was kind and caring. So she is very caring and kind for her friends. And who were her friends? Chimpanzees were her friends. So she traveled all around the world to help save chimps and the forest. Okay, so this tells us that Jane Goodall was kind and caring. Okay, let us move to copy work of this chapter. So children, in first line you have to write down chapter 11, then you have to write down Jane and the chimps, that is the title of the chapter, then new words. Okay children, you have to draw red margins as shown here. Okay, number one is CHIMPANZEES, chimpanzees. Number two, EXCITED, excited. Number three, TOOLS, tools. Number four, DIARY, diary. Number five, OFFERED, offered. Number six, DIFFERENT, different. Number seven, BEGINING, beginning. Number eight, SPECIAL, special. So children, you have to learn all these new words very thoroughly by heart, okay? And you have to do your copy work very neatly, okay? Now let us move to word meaning. Number one is peak. What is the meaning of peak? The highest point, okay? Meaning of peak is the highest point. Number two is special, okay? Meaning of special is different from others, okay? Number three is among. Meaning of among is in the middle of, okay? What is the meaning of among? In the middle of. Now children, let us move to make sentences. In this you have to frame sentences on given word, okay? Number one is danger. Sentence for danger is, there is a danger in going out alone at night. So children, this statement says, or this sentence says, that there is a danger in going out alone at night, okay? Number two is fight. Sentence for this is, we should not fight with others. So children, we should not fight with others. We should always be happy with each other. We should always love each other, okay? We should not fight with each other. Underline the word fight over here. Number three, forest. Wild animals live in forest. So children, this sentence tells us that wild animals live in forest, okay? Now let us move to answer the questions. Question one, what did Jane Goodall love to do as a child? Answer for this is, as a child, Jane Goodall loved watching animals for hours. So what she loved when she is a child? She loved to watching animals for hours, okay? Question two, why did Jane move to Gombe? Answer is, Jane moved to Gombe to watch and write about chimpanzees, okay? What is Gombe? Gombe is a place, is a small forest in Tanzania, famous for its chimpanzees. So she moved to Gombe to watch and write about chimpanzees, okay? Now let us see question number three. What are the two things that Jane learned about chimps? Answer is, the two things that Jane learned are, number one is, chimps can make tools and use them. So what she learned? That chimps can make tools and use them, okay? Number two is, they do eat meat, okay? They not only eat plants, they do eat meat, okay? So children, our chapter is over here. I hope you understood it well and enjoyed it. Thank you.